back on September the 12th of 2001, the Wall Street Journal's John Bussey wrote a front-page, first-person account of the attacks here in Lower Manhattan. It was a poignant and graphic description of a horrific day that shocked the nation and certainly our city. The Pulitzer Prize-winning article began, and I quote, "If there's only one sight I'll remember from the destruction of the World Trade Center, it's the flight of desperation, the headlong leap from the topmost floors by those who chose a different death than the choking smoke and flame. Some fell swinging their arms and legs, looking down as the street came up at them. Others fell on their backs, peering upward toward the flames and the sky. They dropped like dead weight, several seconds, hopeless and unhelpable, always the same end." As people around the world watched it happen on live television, John Bussey was right here in the middle of it all. And like so many who were here that day, he had to run for his life. And the World Trade Center towers came crashing to the ground around him. John Bussey's with us now. He's the assistant managing editor for the Wall Street Journal, which, as our regular viewers know, is owned by the parent company of this network. And I was going back and looking at that, and those feelings came back. And I tell you, one of the things that, as New Yorkers, I think we experienced that other people didn't was the addition of a sense. It was a sense of smell. 9/11 has a smell and a feeling that are all intertwined. And as I read that article, I felt like I was, that column, I felt like I was smelling it again.
It was like concrete, wasn't it? The concrete and the smoke.
And the wire and the, yeah, and the jet fuel. Yeah, and right. Today, yeah, what a stark, stark difference.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, this day looks very much like the day that it happened.
It feels like it.
It's a cool blue sky, kind of sort of beautiful day.
Low humidity.
You know, right around the corner here, and our offices were just right across the street from the World Trade Center, and that's why we had this proximity, this story to tell. I mean, the Pulitzer Prize, you're very nice, but the Pulitzer Prize was won by the paper for a package of stories that day. Mine was just one of them. But the paper basically had to be published from another site because we were knocked out of our offices just like everybody around here.
And now to witness what's happening here, so many people like to say, oh, well, finally they're getting something done. It's not finally. I've been down here every couple of weeks for years now. This isn't a finally. These people are working 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and it just feels great.
Yeah, it's a remarkable thing to kind of come out of the subway and now see buildings going back up. When we moved back into our building, you know, it was a hole in the ground for a lot of years as the city decided, that as the city really metabolized what had happened to it and kind of came to terms with what this site would be. And I think, you know, Shepard, that one thing that you're feeling in the killing of Osama bin Laden, you see, yes, there's some celebrating in the streets, but it's a little bit different for the rest of the country and certainly for a lot of New Yorkers. It's not really celebrating so much as people are thinking about the connection between this, the many people that were killed, many Americans that were killed or wounded in Iraq and Afghanistan, people that were lost in the war on terror. We lost our Danny Pearl as he was reporting on the war on terror. And there's just a moment, I think, Obama coming down here, people in the streets outside of the White House, of national catharsis as opposed to celebration. Osama bin Laden has not been a factor in the terrorism game for quite some time because he's been on the run. He's been, you know, hiding. But he was kind of a symbol of defiance, wasn't he, to America? We simply couldn't find him. And so now that that's been resolved, I think that that's what you're seeing. You're seeing relief, catharsis.
Some of the pictures that we've seen, and I bet our viewers have noticed some of this, a lot of the cheering, and you express your emotions in whatever way works for you. This is personal to every one of us. And however you feel, it's my sense that that's the right feeling. But a lot of the ones who are doing the jumping up and down and screaming are teenagers who might have been little children at that time. And I think those of us who were adults at the time and lost loved ones at the time and remember the smell from the time are really in a sense of relief more than anything else, that our city is maybe ours again on some way.
Yeah, I think that's true. And I think that you're seeing people kind of express that relief in a variety of ways, and many of it way sort of out of the public domain. I think a lot of people are kind of turning to Iraq war veterans and Afghanistan veterans and saying once again, thank you very much for, you know, your service in those countries and taking the risks that you did as a result of the actions we took after 9/11.
John Bussey from the Wall Street Journal, and we've never talked about it before, but that's a part of my life from that time, and
yeah,
I really appreciate that, your work that day. It's good to see you, John.